Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. In the previous update, I warned for a potential large seismic event following the convergence of planetary conjunctions, the quadruple conjunction on the 13th. We didn't have a major seismic event, but if you look at the SSGI graph from 10 to 19 March, and we look at seismic activity magnitude 5.6 and larger, we actually see a clustering of stronger earthquakes starting on the 13th, right at the quadruple conjunction. So here we see that the critical planetary geometry certainly resulted in a seismic response on Earth, but as I explained in the previous update, it very much depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust, how large exactly the seismic activity is going to be. Again, this is magnitude 5.6 and larger, and we see this obvious clustering. Other than that, we didn't have any significant seismic activity. On the 19th, as you can see, we see this peak, that is today, actually this morning. That is a planetary conjunction, and that brings us to the next update. If you look at the SSGI graph from the 19th today to the 28th, we actually see the planetary conjunction here on the left, which is Mercury, Venus and Mars. And because we have this combination of Mercury and Venus with an outer planet Mars, that could become more critical. There could be a stronger seismic event following that planetary conjunction. We have quite some lunar geometry, but not necessarily too critical in the coming time frame. We have high lunar peaks. They involve primarily Jupiter and Uranus. Like I said, not too critical, except possibly for the conjunctions on the 23rd with Venus and Saturn. There can be a seismic response there, a strong seismic activity as a result. And then on the 25th, we have a full moon and also a higher lunar peak. But again, they involve Jupiter and Uranus, and I don't expect that to be too critical. We also have a planetary conjunction, Earth, Venus, Saturn. That is on the 21st, 22nd. On itself, also not critical. So again, we have this Mercury, Venus, Mars conjunction this morning. That could result in a stronger seismic event because we have Mercury and Venus combined. And then this lunar geometry on the 21st, that's with Jupiter and Uranus, and also on the 25th, probably not too critical. And then if we look from the 26th to the 28th, we see the beginning of a clustering of planetary geometry, critical planetary geometry, especially on the 27th and the 28th. And that could result in a major seismic event later on at the end of March, maybe the first days of April. But I will cover that in the next update in much more detail, because that is very significant. And that's the planetary and lunar geometry. If we look at atmospheric fluctuations, we didn't record any significant fluctuations. But we do have the same one fluctuation that I also mentioned in the previous update, and that is still ongoing every day, like clockwork almost. We have a single atmospheric peak, and that still marks this side of the Earth. The line that I drew, which is perpendicular to the plane of the ecliptic, marking the regions near the Aleutian Islands, Alaska, and also the south, the Loyalty Islands. There is nothing else currently that we have recorded. Maybe a good sign. This is the update for now. Until next time.